Get ready to match the stars. Richard Deacon. Fanny Flay. Charles Nelson Reilly. Mary Wicks. Richard Dawson. And Joyce Bulifant. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers!
How are you? Ready? Let's play. Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you, friends, for joining us here. I just... What?
I'm supposed to be on my spot.
Go back to your room. Go back to your room. Just for that, no supper.
They told me to go on my spot.
Who told you to go on the spot?
I'm not supposed to tell.
Oh, listen. No, Pam, we just want to say hello to our friends over here first, and then we'll get you out here on your spot. But I appreciate your enthusiasm and eagerness. It's wonderful to see such spirit, isn't it?
Isn't that pretty? You can do anything you want.
Yes.
Your cold seems much better today.
Yes, it is. Slightly improved. It's sunk to my knees.
It's amazing what 24 hours can do.
Just like that.
It sunk to your knees.
Go on your paper.
Did you hear where Brett really is?
No.
She took a week off to have a frontal lobotomy.
Oh, don't say that. No, Brett.
She'll be a new person when she gets back.
We should explain where she is. She went to visit her son.
That's
who's
right.
At college.
Who's up there in Vermont at Bennington.
And I thought it was very sweet.
He's at Bennington?
Bennington.
I was there for 2 years.
You were?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes, it's a wonderful school.
Should have stayed longer and gotten a degree.
And gotten the smarts.
Yay, Pam.
I don't miss Brett at all.
He says he doesn't miss Brett because Mary Wicks will throw the zingers into him. Now, Pam here, just to point out to all of you who might not have been with us yesterday, has won 2 games. She stubbed her toe on the first game. She got her $100 for that. And just as time expired last time, she won the second game, picked up another $100. Now she's going to have another go at the big money. You ready? Okay. No, not yet. I'll tell you when. During the commercial. Do the commercial and we'll get her out. Here we go with Pamela Cusiora. Ready?
Yes.
All right, let's have another shot at it. And good luck to you. I hope you go all the way this time, Pam. We polled a studio audience and we said, you write down your best answer to this. The deep blank. Remember, if you match the answer they gave us most often, you get $500. For matching the second most popular, you get $250. Then for matching the third, you get $100. And 3 of the 6 loonies will help you.
Okay, I'm going to try with Fanny again.
Okay, the first thing that came into my mind was the deep blue sea.
I'm going to try Joyce.
You want to try?
The first thing I wrote down was the deep blue sea.
Now, what's the second thing that comes to your mind? Think about it. Don't get excited now. Just be calm. Don't get anxiety laden just for a simple little thing like this. Just think
Does
about it.
Does anybody have any ideas in place?
No.
What?
The deep
well.
Oh, yes, that's a good one. I like that. Thank you. Oh, yeah, I like that better. The deep freeze.
The deep freeze. Okay, now you have 2. You need 1 more.
I have to go
Mary,
with Richard.
She gave me hers.
Okay. Richard, please.
Well.
The deep well. So the deep well, the deep freeze, the deep blue sea. Pam are the 3. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Thank you. I'm going to go with Fanny. I want the deep blue sea.
You gave me a good one last time, didn't
That's
you?
That's the way I felt last time with Fanny.
You wanted to do that one, but the audience talked you out of it, huh?
I'm not listening to them anymore.
Oh, all right. Now, she says the deep blue sea is the one she wants, and she hopes it's up there, and so do we. May we see the $100 response? The deep six.
Yeah.
Well, that's an expression that they use in the ocean. It means very deep six, means very deep under the water. You know how those sailors are. May we see the $250 response? The deep end.
Going off.
The sailors go off the deep end all the time. Sailors are very, what's that?
Let's hope they stay with sailors and get to sea.
Oh, yeah, the deep blue sea. That would be another nautical expression, wouldn't it? Okay, may we see it, please? Yeah!
There we go. Very good.
Terrific.
Thank you so much.
Well, Pam, you're getting up there now. You got $700 altogether. You're going to play for 10 times the amount you just won, or $5,000. And remember, we want to give you the money, but you have to match one celebrity exactly.
I'm going to go with my feelings. I'm going to stick with Fanny.
Fanny. Yes. All right. Fanny, Fanny. Okay, here we go. Good luck, Pamela. Worth $5,000. This is it. Blank catalog. Blank catalog. C-A-T-A-L-O-G. Blank catalog. All right. Now, she's made up her mind, Pam. You give us an answer that matches hers. We give you the $5,000. Blank catalog.
All I could think of was Sears catalog.
Sears catalog. Apparently, that's all they could think of, too, judging from the applause. And all except the lady in the front row saying, how did I ever get in this? What am I doing here? You have a problem, madam. All right, no, we'll solve that later. She says Sears catalog will match you for $5,000. Fanny, what do you say?
That's right. Sears.
Sears.
$5,700 all together.
Yay! Yay! That's good. That's good.
You bet it's good. Let's welcome your new player. Here comes Terry Harrell. Terry Harrell. Oh, Terry. Where's it stop? There you go. She's very excited, Terry. She's a winner. She's got $5,700.
It's terrific.
You look like a winner to us, too. Where are you from and all that?
I'm a native of Los Angeles.
Yeah.
I'm a court reporter.
Yes.
I'm married.
Yeah.
And we have... and we have a beautiful brown-eyed St. Bernard named Elmo.
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 That's nice. Do you run one of those machines?
That's what I do.
How many words a minute can you do?
About 225.
Talk 225 words a minute. How fast is that?
I don't think I could. It's fast.
225 words a minute, is that about that fast?
Probably faster.
Really?
Really.
Yeah. Can you talk 225 words a minute, anybody?
I never stop.
No, that's right. All right, good luck to you, Terry. We'll do this game right after we do a little business with America. All right. Now we're ready to begin. And Terry, you may have A or B.
A, please.
A it is, and we are running.
All right.
Jim said it's tough living with a woman that loves indoor gardening because there's a rose bush growing out of the blank. Tough living with a woman who loves indoor gardening because there's a rose bush growing out of the blank. Quiet back here, please. Thank you. All right. Okay, everybody ready up there? Jim said it's tough living with a woman who loves indoor gardening because there's a rose bush growing out of the blank, Terry.
The floor.
The floor?
The floor.
Would that be difficult? I mean, you could just walk aside, walk around it. It might be an interesting decorative piece in the middle of the living room, wouldn't it?
Nope.
Nope.
I thought of John.
John. A thorn. Yes, Fanny.
Yes. I want to save you the trouble. Boo, boo. Sink.
Sink. That's enough. She booed herself. Leave her alone. Charles?
I've used the sink a lot, but this time I said Johnny Bowl.
All right. Terry said right in the middle of the flow. Mary, what'd you say?
Listen, Gene, would you get this message to the producers? Get ugly contestants after this, not these pretty ones. That's all. That's all I want to say. The rose bush is growing in the bathtub.
In the bathtub.
I'm sorry about that. She's
where so is this rose bush growing?
Fine, said a rose.
Is a rose.
She didn't say that.
A rose in the toity, yes. And a thorn. What'd you say?
I said it's a sticky situation. I said the commode.
The commode. Yeah. Another euphemism. Terry, none for you. Now let's see how Pamela does with her first rounder, which is a toughie, too. Tough Teddy is so tough.
How tough is he?
When he wants to clean his ears, Teddy uses a blank. That's how tough he is.
That kid is
tough. Teddy is so tough when he wants to clean his ears, he uses a blank.
Right. And I saw him do it.
Is that what those things are called?
Okay. Well, they're going along pretty good there today, Pam.
I'm not.
Tough Teddy is so tough, Pam, when he wants to clean his ears, Teddy uses a...
A drill.
A drill. That would be a very difficult way to do it, but that would indicate his degree of toughness.
And here's for a very large boo. You may start now when I say sandpaper.
A sandpaper. I think I'll join him. Boo.
Yeah, thank you.
What do you say?
Well, I said corn cob.
A corn cob.
Oh, sure, they applaud that.
That would hurt.
I know someone who can speak 234 words a minute.
Really? Who's that?
Brett. Roto-Rooter.
A Roto-Rooter.
That's funny.
Good one.
That's funny.
Yeah. All right. She is looking for a drill, Mary.
I know she is, but I saw it happen, and the insurance didn't cover it. He used a blowtorch.
Wow. That would be a good way to get the hair out of your ears, too, wouldn't it?
Yeah, well.
To remove the wax, you use a vacuum cleaner.
Vacuum cleaner.
Ooh.
What do you say?
I love my answer.
Another weirdo, eh?
It is. I think this is what you call him, a Charlie's Helper, that just go, up those climbers.
Oh, yeah.
What do you call them?
It's a plumber's friend is what they call him.
Or Charlie.
Well, my plumber's name is Charlie.
And he's a plumber.
No, he's a hamburger.
Terry, if you want to go on with this, Terry, you may have A or B.
I'll try B this time.
B, you had A last time and it didn't work too well for you.
I'll try B this time, Mother.
Dumb Donald is really dumb.
Oh, you bet.
He's dumb.
Oh, my nerves are to the breaking point.
Here's it. He wanted to catch some butterflies.
Of course.
But instead of a butterfly net, he tried to use a blank net. He wanted to catch some butterflies. But instead of a butterfly net, he tried to use a blank net. Dumb Donald is dumb. Wanted to catch butterflies. Instead of a butterfly net, he tried to use a blank net.
Boy, that's dumb.
That is dumb.
This kid is dumb.
Really dumb, dumb, dumb.
Wow.
Okay. Terry, are you thinking about this?
I'm thinking about it.
Well, I'll read it to you one more time while Charles is finishing up. Dumb Donald is really dumb. He wanted to catch some butterflies, but instead of a butterfly net, he tried to use a blank net.
A hair net.
Hair net is good. That would be dumb, wouldn't it? Now, that's not bad. It would be a dumb thing to try to catch a butterfly with a hair net.
A hair net? What is it?
Oh.
That's not amusing, folks.
Hair net. There's one. Very good, Richard. Fanny?
Hi, dear.
Hello, sweetheart.
Well, I was over at Brett's house, and she used this as a hair net. I'm sorry, it was a fish net.
Fish net? That would be another dumb way to do it. Charles?
I don't think either way is dumb.
No?
A hair net or a fish net could catch a butterfly.
Oh. Well, a hair net would be difficult.
No, it wouldn't be difficult. It's exactly the same thing as a butterfly net. Right on. But this would be difficult. A bassinet.
He tried to squirm out of that one, didn't he?
Richard, speak to me after. I can tell you about the hair nets and everything.
If I did, I wouldn't have a career left.
So, Terry, you've got one so far. Mary, she's looking for a hair net. Instead of a butterfly net, he tried to use a hair net.
Right. What are you?
Right.
A hair net.
That's it. Two for Terry. Do you use a hair net?
No, I was trying to think of something that would have a big hole in it.
Something there where the butterfly would escape.
What did you come up with?
A basketball net.
Right.
Yeah.
Good thinking, Ollie.
Thank you.
What do you say?
I heard he was a little bit effeminate, so he used a dragnet.
A dragnet.
Now that's good.
All right, so Terry picked up two. We've got one for you, but right now we've got this for America.
Right.
Thank you, John. I could use some of that Luden's right now. There. Now let's carry on here and finish this game and see how it ends up. Pam, you know what you have to do? Two to tie and three to win. Everyone will play because she didn't match anybody in the first round. Norman's wife said, my husband has a strange sense of humor. In November, he put a don't open till Christmas sign on his blank. My husband has a strange sense of humor. In November, he put a don't open till Christmas sign on his blank.
Can I see it?
Just
a
like Brett. You get up here. Is your butt? What? Is the elevation too high?
Can't think.
He put a don't open till Christmas sign on his blank. Charles is finished.
I know. He certainly
was Brett the one with the loud, raucous voice?
That's right. The one who kept drinking club soda all the time.
Club soda?
Yes. She'll be
the
back
Russian
next week.
Club soda.
Yes. She'll be back next week. All right, Pam, here we go. Norman's wife said, my husband has a strange sense of humor. In November, he put a don't open till Christmas sign on his blank.
On his coat? His trench coat?
On his what?
Trench coat.
On his trench coat. Why would he do that, Pamela?
I don't know anything else you'd open on a person.
Really? You have led a sheltered life, haven't you? Unless she's one step ahead of all of us,
maybe,
and the guy's got nothing underneath the trench coat, and
he's a flasher.
Yeah. Yes. What do you say?
Mine wasn't too much better present.
That is really dreadful.
I'll leave.
No, stick around. We want to hear some of those other baddies you've got. Yes.
Hello. Well, I thought this would be amusing. He put it on his wallet.
Don't open his Christmas seal wallet. Yes. Charles, what do you say?
I have the definitive answer.
You may.
No, I have.
Oh, you
no
do.
May or anything like that about it. On his zipper.
You got it. You have led a sheltered life, haven't you, Pam? Hello there, Mary.
Hi there. See, I thought the operative word was November. See?
Yeah.
I don't know why they stuck November in there, unless it was...
Well, we could have said July.
Put an open till Christmas on these turkey.
And it's turkey.
Oh, I had some people who thought so, too.
Well, many people eat turkey for Christmas, too. Now, Pam, you must match Richard and Joyce to stay in the game
and
achieve a tie. Looking for a coat.
Zipper.
Zipper. So that wins the game for Terry Harrell. And here we go, Terry. Please, get to you in a moment. Pam is leaving here with a total of $5,700. Congratulations, Pam Cugliore.
Thank you very much.
Goodbye, Pam. Now, hello, Terry.
Hello, Gene.
You ready for this?
I think so.
Good. You know how it goes. Not too long ago, we polled a studio audience and we said you write down your best answer to this. Guilty blank. You get $500 for matching their most popular, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third, and three of the six will help.
Fanny.
Guilty as charged.
All right, you got one.
Okay. Charles.
Guilty or not guilty?
Guilty or not guilty, you got two.
And Richard.
He's thinking.
Pardon?
He's thinking.
Well, I have this guilty feeling, and I don't know what to do about it.
Guilty feeling, guilty or not guilty, and guilty as charged are the three, Terry. You can choose one, or you may have a better idea. What is your pleasure?
Guilty or not guilty.
Guilty or not guilty is what we want. May we see it?
Well, don't turn on us.
No.
It may be up there. You may be wrong about that. May we see the $100 number? Guilty verdict. All right. May we see the $250 number? Guilty as charged was Fanny's number. Now, may we see the last one, please? Guilty conscience. Guilty. Richard almost, he had that kind of idea in there, but it didn't work. All right, Terry, we have $100 for you and another player right after we do a little business with America.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 77 of Mark.